has become more desperate as a new round of blizzards push the official death toll towards 50, and millions are still stranded across the country, scrambling to get home for the Lunar New Year.
The worsening situation has prompted Premier Wen Jiabao to go to one of the worst hit areas to get a taste of the continuing chaos.
It's been like this for days on end now, with the chaotic winter weather leaving millions struggling against the bitter cold, trying to escape the nationwide gridlock. And their patience has clearly run out. Enough is enough for these people, among the 500,000 stranded at Guangzhou's main train station, fed up with waiting without sufficient food, water and toilet facilities, not knowing if they can make it back home in time for the Lunar New Year festivities. Riot police had to be called in to control the angry crowds, and officials are still scrambling to find them temporary shelter. Many of them have given up trying to get home, cashing in their train tickets to remain in the city and spend a bitter holiday season far away from their loved ones. For many migrant workers, this is the only chance in a year to visit their families. Officials say traffic on the key Beijing to Guangzhou railway line may not return to normal for up to 5 days. That this will go on. The frustration was just too much for some, who ended up taking it out on police and clashing with them. Large parts of the nation have been crippled by the worst snowstorms to hit China in more than 50 years. The extreme weather has been blamed for nearly 50 deaths over the past 2 weeks. And in the latest incident, a bus plunged 40 meters off a road in Guizhou province, killing at least 25 passengers and injuring 13 others. The crisis is causing alarm all the way to the top in Beijing, and the country's leadership is scrambling to limit the fallout. Premier Wen Jiabao rushed over to one of the worst hit areas, Hunan province, to monitor relief efforts there. Wen flew out of Beijing late last night, but even he was given a taste of what people are going through as the bad weather forced his plane to land in neighboring Hubei province, leaving the premier with no choice but to complete his journey by train.
Hong Kong has been feeling the impact of the bad weather and
開始逼喺廣州火車站嘅幾十萬人咧，有部分喺今日終於都上到車啦喎。
不過與此同時咧，車站嗰度咧一度係有人群推撞啊，場面都幾混亂嘅。係啊，譚家雄啊，當時究竟發生啲咩情況咧？誒，Johnny啊，因為咧班民眾咧都等咗好耐啦。 咁咧，一知道咧有火車開出嘅時候咧，所以都特別心急啊！咁咧，由於天氣又凍啦，咁所以咧佢哋都盡量咧係爭取一個位置咧，盡快上車嘅。情況一度混亂，長情由許作權報導。廣州火車站朝早大閘一開，廣場又再逼滿數以萬計想趕返鄉下嘅旅客。一有風吹草動。 听到任何有关列车开出嘅消息，个个就一窝蜂向前推，前路去路，有人索性爬埋上警察站岗嘅高台。 结果逐个逐个俾警察赶翻落去，铁马都拦唔住汹涌嘅人潮。
又湿又冻，大人挨得住，小朋友就忍受唔到啦。
那肯定要在这里等咯，我不可能又跑过来，是不是？肯定带个小孩，你看他这么冷，又麻烦。
为咗防止再发生混乱，当局立即加强警力，限制住进入广场嘅人数。
成个火车站变成战场一样，但系喺广场嘅外围，仍然有数以万计嘅人争取入嚟。 等待渺茫嘅回乡希望。有线电视记者许作权喺广州嗰度。
谭家恒啊，咁至于成功上到车嗰班旅客咧，佢哋大约有几多人咧可以咁好彩赶得切翻乡下过年咧？
今日咧大概有廿几班列车开出啦，咁大约咧系有5-6万嘅人咧可以离开广州呢度噶。咁咧因为上车咁困难啦，咁所以上到车嚟讲咧系特别开心噶，有啲咧更加系感动到落泪添。咁林建成同一啲乘客倾过，
翻屋企啦，终于可以翻屋企啦。归心似箭嘅旅客似乎忘记晒过去几日嚟嘅辛苦，一窝蜂咁涌向停喺站台嘅列车。膊头上的行李无论几重都不紧要，最紧要上到车嘛。孭住咁大包的行李，车厢难入都不紧要啦。等咗咁耐咯，呢啲已经停用咗超过10年的柴油动力火车，在呢一刻大派用场，塞满一车又一车。呢一批湖南旅客上到车，放好行李，有座位的倒头就瞓觉。瞓唔着嘅咧，當然要報下平安先啦。
站這裡心裡很激動啊！哎呀，有點想哭。
按照我自己的包，自己的行車父母。
今次恐怕冇位坐咯。等咗幾日幾夜，旅客終於可以翻屋企啦。旅客最期待嘅一刻就係開車嘅一剎那。有線電視記者林建成喺廣州報道。
咁港鐵話咧，今日一共係推出咗30萬張票㗎。咁佢哋除咗唔會再發售新嘅車票之外咧，亦都會繼續勸喻民眾咧，盡快辦理退票手續㗎。咁喺度報道暫時咁多啦，而家先將成家分俾兩位啊。
好，唔該曬譚家恆噶。嗱，廣州有人就終於等到，所以上到車。不過喺內地各地嘅天氣咧，就仍然係好差㗎。唔好似喺上海咁啊，朝早就因為落大雪咧，機場一度係需要關閉㗎。係李炳權啊，機場嘅服務咧，而家恢復翻正常未咧？
旅行上啊，機場服務咧可以話咧係逐步咁恢復正常。不過咧，由於係積壓咗大量嘅航班，琴日有幾百班航班係積壓咗落嚟噶，所以咧好難話一時一刻咧可以清得到咁多嘅旅客。喺機場所見咧，我哋之前仍然係見到咧打蛇餅嘅打蛇餅啊，排長龍嘅排長龍，仍然咧係好多旅客咧等咗幾日飛機咧都係上唔到機噶。喺航空公司面前咧係排滿曬旅客啦。咁啊，加上咧係唔同空域之間嘅調度啦，係一下間咧咁多飛機咧重開咗，或者咧係之前積壓咗咧係要再安排咧，所以都會有一定嘅困難。睇到咁樣嘅情況咧，唔少個旅客咧就係話已經係打定輸數噶啦，諗住咧今晚咧都係未必翻得到去噶。
我們要回家，我們要回家，我們要回家，
呢批準備翻武漢嘅旅客買咗廉價航空公司嘅機票，等咗3日都冇飛機。佢哋話航空公司仍然未答覆幾時安排到航班俾佢哋。希望當局可以幫手協調。
我們已經住了，已經在這裡2天2夜了，都沒喝過鹽，而且東西也沒有吃，他們也不安排我們住宿，還有我們自費。
啲旅客又展示喺爭取過程之中同公安人員推撞嘅片段。除咗廉價航空，內地多間航空公司嘅航機都有唔同程度嘅延誤或者取消，當局將會視乎天氣嘅情況進一步調度。到咗下晝，上海浦東國際機場嘅航班情況都冇乜大嘅改善，各個航空公司嘅區域依舊係逼滿曬人。稍有一個機位空出嚟，全部人都爭相爭奪。連公安都要協助航空公司的職員加快疏導旅客。民航部門就宣布啦，較早前封閉的長沙同埋武漢機場已經係開翻噶啦，不過仍然係需要一定的時間才可以回復正常的服務噶。好啦，我喺上海講到呢度，交翻俾兩位啊。
好啊，唔該曬李炳權嘅。咁而總理温家寶就趕到去湖南嗰度視察救災嘅進度。他話首先解決長沙到韶關的電力安全和供應和鐵道暢通，這個問題解決就可以激勵到全國的信心。不過有巴士乘客就埋怨，因為溫家寶的來到視察，公路變得更加擠塞。由許秋霞講下。
大風雪下，在廣東打工的小林由東莞上車，一坐就6日，車上沒有水沒有食物，試過下車投靠附近的村莊。
龙庄里面吃饭，所以很贵啊，吃一次一个泡面都要50块钱，六天来我只吃了一顿饭。
食得少又只是得-6度，车上用晒燃油，暖气都冇埋，
什么都没有，很冷，现在车厢里面乱七八糟的，小孩老是哭，老人也很冷，很多人都感冒了，很饿又没有饭吃。
他们坐的车上星期四出发，正常14个钟头就去到湖北，但一日之后在湖南衡阳开始被困，到现在还在湖南境内。下午部分公路开翻，怎知警察又拦翻条路。
湖南政府的人，然后令警车拦在那里，路全部封死。他说等温家宝过来看了之后才让我们走，很过分啊，这样子作假。
他说都开始有军人来派感冒药，但他最希望是可以快点回到家。有线电视记者许秋霞报道。
来往本港和内地的交通亦都是很受到今次封雪的影响。
没错，有三班京九和沪九的列车仍然滞留在途中，未知道何时才可以到步。港铁方面就说未来几日预计天气都仍然会恶劣，呼吁乘客退票，持票人可以在30日内到红磡车站又或者是买飞的地点退票。至于滞留的三班列车就分别停了在英德、衡阳和武汉附近。
各位，我哋而家先休息一阵，翻嚟咧会同大家讲下咧，就系粉面商会啊，唔再坚持叫业界加价，咁但佢哋就话生意难做，叫马时亨教下佢哋。
小巴司机冇留意车门夹住女童照开车，令女童死亡，判监4个月。
又会睇下消防署添置咗一批嘅救援装备噶，唔好见呢一架救火车喷出嘅泡沫咧，长过 A380空中巴士。
中药里面嘅有效成分。